Hello, welcome to another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. A while back, I was on a hunting trip, and Charlie, the fellow I was with, buddy of mine, him and I, we had this nice camp set up, and we had a wall tent made out of the inexpensive poly tarps that you can get at the hardware stores. Charlie had made this tent. It was a fantastic tent. And we had a wood stove in there, and we had a fire out front for cooking on, and a tarp over the top to keep the rain off of us. And it rained. It was raining, and I was sitting there by the fire when all of a sudden it dawned on me, you know, maybe I'm not entirely under the tarp here like I thought. I looked up, and sure enough, my backside was out from underneath the tarp. I reached back, and the back of my vest here, this cotton vest, was very, very wet, very soaked. So I'm going to show you what I did to dry it out. Also, several other methods of drying out the clothes. I recently did a video on keeping clean in the woods clothes, how to wash them, a little trick that I showed on how to wash your clothes. Okay, well, somebody asked in that video, okay, now that you got your clothes washed, how are you going to dry them? So that's also an answer to that as well. So come along with me. I'll show you what I did with my vest first to get it dry. Okay, what I've got here is I cut an alder branch, a green alder branch, and if you notice, I cut it just below a branch. This is the way it grew on the tree. I cut it just below the branch on the tree. We're going to make a hanger. Now, the reason why, if you just hang up an article of clothing like this, it's all gathered together and it takes a lot longer to dry. So I wanted a hanger to be able to spread it out so it'd dry faster. Okay, so let's get started on our hanger. Okay, so there's where it's going to hang on the string. Now let's go down a little ways here, I'll say about here, and we'll cut that off. Okay. Okay. Now, we're going to put a cross piece on this. First of all, let's decide how long of a cross piece we need. So this will be our cross piece. It needs to be a little less than shoulder width. So about there. So let's cut that off. Actually, let's cut it off from the other end. Okay, cut it off right there. All right. Now we're going to put this on right here. Okay. So about right here. We need to carve a groove into this. So about like that. It goes without saying, whenever working with knives, be extremely careful that you don't slip and cut yourself, especially when you're out in the woods like this, because you don't need an accident to happen. Okay, now if I was doing this for real, I would baton this notch out, but the reason why I'm not doing it now is because I would have to change the camera angle, and I'm lazy, so we'll just keep on with it as it is. Okay, hopefully you can see that. Got this angle right here. Okay, I'll make that a little bit wider. Okay, that looks pretty good right there. Now what we need to do is okay, now if you notice your shoulders slope down. They're not, straight across. They slope down. So this got a little bit of a bend in it. It's bent down a little bit here. We're going to use that to our advantage, and we're going to place it on the hanger just like that. So what we want to do is we want to peel off the side right here, right in the middle, to make a kind of a V to fit in our notch. So, okay. The V notched out there. Let's see how it fits. Okay, actually it's a sharper V than I need, so we'll shallow it out a little bit here so that it fits in here tighter. That's starting to look pretty good. Shallow it out just a little bit more. Yes, that fits real good now. All right, now we've got to lash it together. So we need some string. Hopefully I got some string handy here. That's why I bring my man purse, my vest. I got anything and everything in this vest. So let's get this string strung out and lash this together. Okay, now you want to make sure when you put it together that you've got your cross piece angled the correct way. Now, this string is pretty kinky. It's got a lot of kinks in it. It's hard to work with. So I am going to warm it up just briefly over the fire. OK. Okay, a little bit more. Not too much, you don't want it to melt. Okay, that took a lot of the kink out of it. All right, now tie a clove hitch to start this off with. And slip it over our cross piece. All right. Again, making sure, excuse me, that this angle's down in the correct direction. All right, and then we start a regular standard lashing technique. Okay. Excuse me. Alright, there's our hanger. It's very sturdy. It's not going to, you know, it's not going to slip. And that'll work real well. Let's go try it out. Okay, let's string this up a string here. All right, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make a bite right here, a loop. Twist it around a couple of times, reach through and grab the rope behind, pull it through, making a loop, okay? And then run the end, the working end through that loop and cinch it up tight. All right, now when we get ready to pull this down, we just pull and that loop comes out of here. Okay, let's put that in there again. Okay. Pull it tight. Okay. All right. Now, let's try out our hanger. Okay, you want to make it fairly stout, especially since it's out of green wood. Because over time, it can sag, possibly even break. So, there you go. It's got it spread out to maximize the surface area of it so it can dry quickly. Now you want to have this strung up close to the fire, but of course you don't want it too close to the fire to where heat could damage it. All right. Let's go on with the next project. All right, there's times where you need to hang up something to dry and a hanger won't work, you know, such as a pair of wet gloves or a stocking hat or some socks or something. Okay, so what we're gonna do here, we've got a little alder branch here. We're gonna attempt to split this and make a clothespin. All right, so now, as you can see, there's a knot right here, and we're gonna use that to our advantage. We're gonna split this right down through here, and hopefully the knot will stop the split. So you want to place this right exactly in the middle of the growth rings. You can see the growth rings in the end of the stick when you've got a stick cut like this. All right, there's our clothespin. Now to aid in keeping it open, might be handy to break you off a little stick here and slide it in. Okay. Now, that's one type. Now let's make a different type. Here we've got another alder. We're going to saw this halfway through, approximately halfway through. Okay, that looks pretty good. Now what you do is you bend it. As you notice, when you bend it, it starts to split off to the side here. Okay, this side is splitting pretty good. So let's go ahead and work that up a little bit. Now we got to get the other side to split. Okay. We've got the other side split pretty good. There we go. Let's work that a little bit. All right, now, of course, we don't want our clothes pin to be that big, so let's cut it off a little bit shorter. Here's a knot. So we're going to cut it, and here's our split right here. So we're going to cut it just past the knot. So that knot will, well, hopefully aid us and not splitting anymore. All right. Cut off this end a little bit shorter. Okay, there's our clothespins. Let's go try them out, see how they work. We got a stocking hat here. Hopefully this is light enough for you out here. The sun is starting to go, the daylight. We're starting to lose the daylight here. Okay, there's that. Seems to work pretty good. You know, if the wind's blowing, the wind can blow on that and it'll stay. All right, now let's try out the glove. There, same with the glove. It's on there real good. Okay, here's the stocking hat. And with the split stick clothespin. And here's the glove with this type of clothespin. Before I sign off here, I just want to say that Connie and I really appreciate you guys. We've developed relationships with folks all over this world. And you guys are awesome. And I really want to thank you for the support you've given to us. Well, thanks for joining me for another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. We'll see you on the next one. You guys take care.